really has been for the last 48 hours generating the most interest and captivating so much of the United States is the backlash that's still occurring as a result of Proposition 8, essentially banning gay marriage in the state of California. Look at this. Look at these pictures that we've been... 300 different cities in the United States had protests over the weekend. These are some of the cities that we've been watching in Boston, Oklahoma City, Orlando. I mean, these are from Los Angeles. There were also protests in rallies in Atlanta. This one you're looking at here. Look at the number of people at this. This is KGO from San Francisco. Even protests from Boise, Idaho that have been taking place over the weekend. There's Boston, WHDH. We thank them for their video. We've got too much video to be able to show you. In fact, if we just did nothing but show video, we could use the entire hour. That's how massive some of these protests have been. We'll stay with some of these pictures. We'll dip into them. We'll show them to you. But in the meantime, I want to introduce a couple of people who are very much tied to this particular story. First, I want you to meet Molly McKay. She's the media director for Marriage Equality USA. There she is. Let me just start with you, Molly. This story seems to be taking on a life of its own. There's a real backlash. I mean, a real credible backlash that's now going on in this country. Some people would watch this and say, why so riled up? What are these folks protesting?
Well, I think this is really a tipping point in American civil rights for LGBT Americans. I really feel that our community has stood up nationwide to say, the world spins forward, and though we, of course, are heartbroken over the loss of Prop 8, it was so incredibly close. What we're saying is that the world spins forward. We are, our victory, our equality for all people is an American principle and tradition that has been extended over time, and we're not going back.
American principle, that's an interesting point that you make. We do have, by the way, a little bit of a problem with your microphone. It almost sounds like it's a little bit away from you. So while you get that straight, I want to bring in Lou Engle. He's the founder of TheCall. And he's against gay marriage. He's good enough to join us as well. You heard her say this is an American principle. By denotation, then, I guess what she's saying is that it's un-American to oppose this. How would you respond to that?
Well, I would just like to just say that the people that voted for marriage between a man and a woman, they weren't hating anybody. They were simply saying, we believe that this is the foundations, the best for society. It seems to me that right now the rage and the hatred is directed to a people that don't have hatred. And I'm afraid for where America is going, because if this is freedom, then I'm afraid there's a lot of people going to suffer because of it.
Do you hate the people, Molly, who are protesting against gay marriage?
Of course not. And what we believe is that we need to continue to have dialogue about equality under the law. I respect everyone's religious beliefs, not asking to get married in any church that doesn't want to marry us, but I'm saying that our Constitution has always stood for the principle of equality under the law, and there is no reason to have sexual orientation discrimination. And it's, we want to get married. We want to protect our families like anybody else. So, of course, we don't hate anyone.
Let me take that over to Lou. Lou, if it has nothing to do with your particular church or your organization or your community, and it's just something that's done in an organization or a church that invites it, why should it bother you?
Well, the redefinition of marriage is going to affect the whole society from education on down. And so when you're saying it's a civil rights issue, we don't believe it's a civil rights issue. We believe that people can live the way they want to, but to redefine the very foundations of society. We see what's happening in Europe. Basically, marriage is just going out the door, and it ends up hurting children.
So what if the word, if it's a semantic argument, what if the word marriage was taken out and it were called a union? Molly, would that be okay with you? Lou, would that be okay with you?
Yes, that's fine with us. We're saying that's fine, but let's not redefine the very basic foundations that have been with society for generations and centuries, really. And, you know, God designed, and a benevolent designer set it between a man and a woman. Let's not change
the definition of marriage. The definition of marriage has changed over time. It's a loving partnership of two adults. Sexual orientation is discrimination is wrong, and the trends are proving this. If you look at the age in the difference and divide, clearly young voters get this. They don't know what in the world the fuss is all about. We want to be married. We have the same commitment. We love the same. We bleed the same. Our families, you know, I'm going up to Thanksgiving with my in-laws like everybody else is going to be doing next week. We just simply want to live our lives
with the
same protection under the law.
Where does this take us, though? Look, it looks, Lou, to me anyway, watching this thing develop over the last 72 hours, that these protests are not going to go away. Is there a compromise? First you, Lou, and then Molly, before we wrap this up.
Well, I know that believers believe in the foundations of what we believe, the Word of God. People will not compromise on this. They will stand on the foundations of truth. Here in California, they've already changed the definition of gender. A young lady is now sharing a bathroom in a public school with a young man, with a young man's bathroom, because of the gender change. We can't keep just opening the door for everything. Polygamy is coming.
I get you, and I think our viewers understand. You are making a stand, and you're not willing to give in on this. Where does that leave you, Molly?
We want simple equality. We want the same thing as everyone else wants. And I just ask to anyone who wants, you know, sort of a compromise to say, you know, if we had said back in 1967, when the Loving v. Virginia decision came up, that, you know, interracial marriage is controversial and the majority of Americans don't support you. So why don't you have an interracial marriage, interracial union? Is that going to be sufficient? And of course, the answer is no. We're all one people. We all deserve equality under the law.
It's interesting that you mentioned Thanksgiving dinner, because it sounds like the type of thing that many Americans are probably going to be mulling over themselves as they sit down to eat that dinner this year. We'll keep following the story as well and the protest. My thanks to both of you. Lou, Molly, thanks so much for being so respectful and being with us.
Thank you very much.
There's a